So let's start. First, who am I? Well, my name is Dick Rensma. I'm a web developer at Onesho, currently a senior web developer. I have over 10 years experience with Drupal. Last time I checked, I'm at almost 12 years at Drupal.org. So my account's getting pretty old. You can find me as Dutch Yoda, and also on Twitter you can find me as Dutch Yoda. So the premise of my talk, so the intro, is if the internet was a country, we would rank 6th for electrical usage. So what does that mean? Well, basically we have these countries. Well, European Union isn't a country, but I mean, we can consider Europe on its own. Those will rank higher, but then for all the signals that we send for our data, if we combine all that together, we will be the 6th after Russia. So about 1700 million tons is the current size of the internet's annual carbon footprint. So that's quite a lot. And compared to the other countries, it's basically okay. I see that China is, well, the biggest polluter. Then we have the United States, Europe, India, and then Russia. And then, of course, the internet, if we would consider it a country. But, of course, those are split up over all the countries as well. So how did we calculate this? So in 2008, there was a paper which suggests that it takes 13 kilowatt hour to transmit 1 gigabyte. I don't know how they exactly proved it, but that's how they measured it. So the average power plant in the United States, because every research was done in the United States, is 1.2 pounds of carbon dioxide equivalent. So not really carbon dioxide, but how many carbon dioxide it would use to deliver 1 kilowatt hour. So this would result in 15.6 pounds of carbon dioxide equivalent to transfer 1 gigabyte. Basically just 13 times 1.2, of course. Then the average page size has a size of 1.4 megabytes. That's including images, all the scripts, that sort of things. So if 1 million users visit a page, that would generate over 10 tons of carbon dioxide equivalent. So, and then if you combine how many websites are there, you calculate to that, then you can come to the 1700 million metric tons. So what can we do to be more green? Well, I'm going to look at hosting. What can we do for hosting? What can we do for performance? What can we do about design and UX? But also, what can we do about search engine optimization and our findability? So, it's just simple to think, well, web servers run on electricity. They run the whole day through 24/7. So make sure that you use a green hosting party. That's a given if you want to do that. But there are hosting parties that work with renewable energy credits. That means that they did not actually use green energy. They could have, but it's not guaranteed because they could have bought those credits from a company that did do green energy. So be aware, if they use it, there is green energy somewhere, but it doesn't mean it's for you at that point. So what do we have more for hosting? Use a virtual private server or shared hosting account. So if you combine everything, it's just like carpooling. If you're on the same server, it's virtually private, but technically you're on the same server, then you're carpooling. So if you're carpooling, you don't have another server that uses energy or another server that uses energy. So you use all the energy together, which is just like carpooling. It's better for the environment. Use a CDN. Most of the time, you can use a CDN to help and shorten the distance between you and between the site and the person that's visiting your site. So if you have a lot of people coming from the European Union, make sure that you have, if you use a CDN, use a CDN within the European Union. If there's a lot of people coming from the USA, make sure you have a CDN that you use within the USA. Just make the distance shorter, because the distance shorter means the signal's getting there faster. Even though electrical signals are really fast, it will still be faster if the distance is shorter, which means lesser used energies. So if you're building a local website, make sure that you also use the local CDN. Like I said, if it fits in your demographic. If you're making a website that's global, then it doesn't make sense to use CDN for for one specific location. You may use a CDN that's better fit for global use. And of course, make sure you have your caching turned on. That could be memory-based caching that delivers the page faster, but it loads faster. It prevents rotation on hard disks, even though with solid state drives that's no longer the case. But in the old time, it would cost more energy to rotate the hard disk. But now, use caching. Memory caching is still faster than a solid state hard drive. So set up your caching accordingly. Which brings us to the performance, which is basically the same thing. Use proper caching. Don't make the machine reload and rebuild the page every time there is a call. Just make sure you use your caching correctly. Aggregate your JavaScript and your CSSs. It's pretty simple. If you are moving somewhere, you're not going to drive one box up and down and another box up and down. Or you're going to fill your car as full as you can, or your truck. Then you go there and unload it. And then maybe you come back for more. So make sure that you do that. There are enough sites that still forget it, but just do that, and it will help you so much. Proper use of images. If I'm looking on my phone, yeah, my phone has a pretty nice resolution, but I still don't need a picture that's 4,000 pixels wide or high. That doesn't make sense. So make sure that your images just are properly placed. If you use smaller images for mobile and bigger images for desktop, just make sure that you use the proper image styles to accompany that. I'm no front-ender, but I know there are tricks to do that. So make sure that you do that. Next up is the you designing user experience. Like I said, proper use of images. It's from one into the other. It just makes sense to make the image the smallest it should be and the biggest it should be. And maybe somewhere in between for tablets or anything, but just make the proper size. And maybe if you use another lot of icons, combine them together so it's just one image that's being loaded, like I said, with the aggregation of CSS and JavaScript. Design your websites mobile first. That's also a thing you can do, because the mobile first part is the, most of the time it's the smallest part that you're showing. So you don't, like I said, you don't want to have the big images. You want to keep it nice and intact. So make a proper mobile first design, and then make the site bigger if the resolution calls for it. The use of colors. Lately, well, the couple of past years, it's a trend to have dark modes. You have dark modes in your web, in your webmail, dark modes. If I think even YouTube and Twitch, if you use it, have a dark mode. They'll save battery power, mostly on your phone. If you use a dark mode, darker colors save up to 30% of electrical usage. Not in the signal that is being sent back and forth, but it saves the client or the person watching your website. It saves them up to 30% power. So their carbon footprint is lower. So the overall carbon footprint is lower. Of course, you have to discuss this with your client if you want to enable a dark mode, make the whole site a little bit darker, or just if the client says, yeah, I'm not going to do that, just tell them any reason if it would benefit them or not. If it doesn't fit the brand, of course it's hard to do, but if it does fit the brand, maybe convince them to do so. So the use of fonts. There are some basic fonts that are in every browser. You have your Times New Roman, your Arial, that sort of fonts. So they don't need extra loading. So if it fits, if you can agree with the client to do that, that prevents extra loading. Embedded fonts increase the website size of your website. So it will also take longer to get all the information. And if you use web fonts, so not non-embedded, but loaded from somewhere else, you increase the requests, which still makes more signals, more communication between servers. So it will take longer to get everything. And it will make sure that you have a longer electrical period and use more carbon dioxide equivalent. Now we're going to search engine optimization findability. If you make sure that you have a proper setup. Okay, that was, I didn't know if you could hear that, but they are playing with fireworks near me. Where was I? Oh yeah, if you want, if you set up your website properly for search engine optimization findability, that means that people can find you faster. It's just like if you're driving and don't know exactly where you're going and your navigation is off, then maybe Google will help you find your way. Not, and I'm not meaning Google Maps in this case, but normally you can read the road signs and everything. So if you have your CEO ready, then Google will provide the road signs for people to find you. And they don't search too much on the internet. The less they search on the internet, the less energy they consume, the smaller the carbon footprint. Use the redirects. Well, that's also a good thing for your search engine optimization. So you don't have any 404s, because if people driving through a dead-end street, they still have to get back and find another entrance. So make sure that everything works. Create redirects if necessary. And if there are three or two pages, make sure you add a login so they can log in quickly and not that they see the page, or oh, you're not allowed to be here, or I mean a 4-3, well, 302, I mean a 4-3. If they aren't allowed, then yeah, please click here to log in, and then they go to login form, or you should show the login form directly, which saves another page call. So those are the points I have in making your page greener. So if you want to see how you can make your page greener, how green your page is, you can go to ecograder.com that checks your website. Let me see if I can pull up a screen for you to show that. I did not share my window. So now I see the chat. Finna, thank you. Yeah, I have a lot of games. So let me, I'm gonna stop sharing for 1 minute and I'm gonna share my complete window, which makes more sense. There it is. So for one, let's do triplejam.nl. Let's see. I'm not gonna put in my email address because then they will stalk me, but now it's gonna check how green drupalgem.nl is. So it's pretty good. It scores a 70 out of 100. So that's green. It's still a nice score. So here you see what pages they are, what kind of ranking they give. So we have the HTTP request and the MOS rank. So I'll click here. There are 47 HTTP requests only based on the front page. So, and then they give tips, enable caching, use the sprites, embed your images in CSS. So make everything a little bit faster. So we have the findability. So there's a score of 3.2 on a scale from 1 to 10. And then they give suggestions for that as well. So if you want to see how what you can do for to make your site greener, just check it. So are there any other sites you might want to see? Any suggestions on a site you want to see? Maybe let's see how good Google itself is. Oh no, I don't want to send tips. Google is a pretty small site, so should run be pretty fast, right? 79, all green, but still not a perfect 100. So you can look. Well, the Google page speed is 99. Well, that makes sense. It's Google. So still 19 page requests for as little as you see. So that's pretty much. Shared resources is nice. The findability of Google itself is a 7.4. So that's funny. Google has a hard time finding Google. We'll avoid Flash. Well, Flash is really old. We shouldn't use that anyway. So in the hosting part, so what I always like to do, let's see how our government does it. Because they should be the prime example, right? Was taking a lot of long time. Really long time. didn't use it for foresight, right? No, the. Okay, maybe we don't do that. So I'm going back to the presentation. Almost done with the presentation. Only have 5 minutes left anyway. I have to see my own part as well. So this is a message I want to share. Well, we don't need a handful of people to be green perfectly. We need millions of people to be green imperfectly. Because if everybody does a little, it saves a lot more than if just a couple of people are being so green. So if you can be green in some stuff, but you can't be in another because you have to travel a lot, okay, you still have that. But if you can still do other stuff. I mean, you can ask your own company, our energy partner, so the one that gives energy to your building. Is that a green party? Do we get green energy or is it not green? You can ask all that sort of things to your own company, of course. I don't even know it for my company because we have been busy with a merger, so maybe it's time I can finally ask that question. So, do you have any questions? Let me check if we cannot recognize that URL. Overhead.nl is still a website, right? It is. So why don't you recognize it? Can we get a link to my slides? Yeah, I will make it available this weekend. I will put them up. I don't have a link ready yet. It's just a PowerPoint presentation. I'm going to use them in some web-based slide program. So I'll put them up and share them. So yeah, and basically it's most of the stuff we already do as web developers. We keep the lower image. We make sure that we do everything correctly and do SEO correctly. Well, thank you for the kind words. I have fun doing this talk. So I don't think overhead.nl is working. So you guys want to see any other website? Oh, the obvious one, of course, drupal.org. Come on. Well, let's make sure it stopped first. So drupal.org. Come on. I don't think it wants to work with me anymore. Seriously? Drupal.org. Come on. Thinking it was still working on the overhead.nl. It's not working anymore. Well, nope, didn't recognize it. Okay, too bad. I don't know what happened. I know that when I did this presentation at my company, we checked some client sites as well. We suggested some improvements to them, which you can do as well. You can say, well, if you want to appear more green, just make sure we fix this. So thank you everybody for showing up. Sharing. I had a great time. I'm gonna do a quiz at the One Shoe booth in a little over half an hour. A small quiz. There were only two people at 2:30, and so the chance of one winning was 50-50. There will be a prize at the end, so if you want to show up, That will be fun. If you don't, yeah, then don't. And if you have something else to do, because there are a lot of sessions, I don't mind. So, thank you, everybody. And I think I'll stop.